Unfortunately, my brother was killed by a drink driver when he was 12 years old on his bicycle. So, abso-bloody-lutely. I don't know about the straight-to-jail business. Obviously, if you kill somebody, yeah. But as far as sort of, you know, first offence, drink driving, straight-to-jail, I definitely think there should be a hell of a lot stronger penalties. This is an argument I'm having with the Road Safety Commission in Victoria at the moment, one of the issues on the table. And it's... I'll go back to some years ago. I was fighting a speeding fine in yes, I was speeding. But I was fighting this was one point on my license, and I think about $150 fine. And I decided to stay in the courtroom before my case was heard, just to sort of have a listen to the other cases. About 90% of the cases were drink driving, and I was absolutely astounded that the magistrate was. There was one chap in particular. And it wasn't one, it wasn't two, it was the fifth time he had been in front of that magistrate on a drink driving charge. And do you know, she had the audacity to turn around and go, all right, well, look, you know, you've clearly got a problem. We'll fit your car with an interlock device, which is you blow into it and you can't start your car if you've got a blood alcohol reading. And I just, hang on a second, the fifth time, this guy is... He is a killer. He's not a potential killer anymore. He is a killer. He's a killer on the loose behind an incredibly lethal weapon. So, no, stop. That sort of situation is... this guy obviously cannot... He's beyond help. Get him in jail where he's away from people.
Tell us about when your brother died. Did they catch the person?
Yes, they did.
And did they punish him?
Yes, they did.
What did they do?
How much do you think he was fined?
So he didn't go to jail?
No, he didn't go to jail. He was the son
$1,000?
$200. Yeah, $200. And that same weekend, somebody killed a koala. They weren't drunk, and because koalas are a protected species, got something like five times that fine.
And did that change the whole course of your young life as his brother, and I guess for your parents as well?
Yeah, and that's the thing, and that's what people don't realise is, yeah, it's all very well to talk about drink drivers and, oh, don't do it and all of that, but what the repercussions of somebody's actions by getting behind the wheel on drugs or drink or any impairment to your driving is devastating to the people involved. Mm. Not to, obviously, you know, the person that killed, it doesn't bother them anymore because they're dead, but certainly the people around them, it affects them for the rest of life. It's, you know, this happened... decades and decades ago for me, but it still affects me. It's actually, I'm more affected today than I was back then because I was only a little kid then.
Yeah.
Has the law changed, Stefan, in Australia now? Would that still be the case, that there would not be a custodial sentence and a risible fine of $200?
It depends how good your lawyer is. You know, but you can. There are situations where people have killed people on the road there and essentially got off, yeah.